Hello student, in this video we will discuss about the chapter number 4, that is carbon and its compound. So as you know, the carbon having the atomic number 6, and we can write the electronic configuration of carbon, that is 2 and 4. Now from the electronic configuration we can understand the valency of carbon, that is 4. And from here we will discuss about the occurrence of carbon in the atmosphere. So it is present 0.03% in the form of carbon dioxide, while in the mineral form it is present 0.02%, and the total number of carbon present at earth crust, that is 0.05 carbon. Now student, we will discuss here why the carbon cannot form ionic compound. Carbon cannot form ionic compound because carbon either not release or gain the electron. Because carbon require 4 electron to get noble configuration like neon, and to release 4 electron to get noble configuration like helium. So it is not possible to become cation and anion. So now question is here, why carbon cannot form cation? Because carbon need to release 4 electron to become a cation. So to release a 4 electron, the high energy is required, so that carbon would not convert into the cation. While carbon will not form anion because of whenever the carbon will get 4 electron, so it will having the 10 electron, so because of that the carbon nucleus cannot able to hold 10 electron. So now how then carbon get the noble configuration? So most of the time, or should I say, carbon share the electron with another element and form the covalent bond. So sharing of the electron is known as covalent bond. If any element share one electron, so it will form single bond. If any element share two electrons, so it make two bond, yes, or double bond, and so on. If any electron share 3 electron, so it will form the triple bond. Then student, we will here discuss about the characteristics or the properties of the carbon. So most of the time if we discuss about the property of the carbon, so it is having 4 valency, so that is known as tetravalency. And carbon can form the long chain carbon compound, so that property is known as cationation. So these two property are very versatile for the carbon, because of these two property carbon form long chain compound naturally. Now student, we will discuss here why silicon does not form long chain compound like the carbon. Because silicon belong to the group of carbon, it is also having the 4 electron in its outermost shell, but the valency of silicon is 4, but the nucleus of silicon cannot hold the 10 electron in the long chain carbon compound. It can form the long chain carbon compound, but up to 5 to 7 atom containing compound. Then student, here we will discuss about the allotropes of the carbon. So first one is a diamond. So diamond, if we talk about the structure, so it is having the 3-dimensional structure, and it is the insulator of electricity, because 4 electron of the carbon in the structure of diamond are the bonded with the another 4 carbon, So there is no free electrons. Because of that, diamond is the insulator of electricity. Apart from that, the diamond having the hardest solid or naturally hardest substance, and the use of the diamond mostly in the jewelry and to cut the soft item like marble and the glass. So these are the properties of the diamond. Then we will discuss here in the another allotropes, that is a fluorine, that is a graphite. So graphite having the hexagonal structure, you can see on the structure of the graphite. So the hexagonal structure of the graphite having here, and you can see one carbon is attached with the three carbon only. So because of that, the one electron of each carbon is free. So that electron move in the structure due to resonance, and because of that, graphite is the conductor of electricity. Yes, then if we talk about the solid, so it is a soft solid because these hexagonal layers can slips over each other, and because of that, the graphite is the soft solid. It is used in a pencil and lubricant. Okay, thank you.